Reading from Crowley. Again. Let your will to love burn eagerly toward this creation in yourselves of the true life that rolls its waves across the shoreless sea of time. Live not your petty lives in fear of the hours, the moon, sun, and stars by which you measure time are themselves but servants of that life which pulses in you. As joyous drum beats, as you march triumphant through the avenue of the ages. Then, when each birth and death of yours are recognized in this perception as mere milestones on your ever-living road, what of the foolish incidents of your mean lives? Are they not grains of sand blown by the desert wind, or pebbles that you spurn with your winged feet? Or grassy hollows where you press the yielding and elastic turf and moss with lyrical dances? To him who lives in life, naught matters. His is eternal motion, energy, delight, of never-failing change. Unwearied, you pass on from eon to eon, from star to star. The universe, your playground, its infinite variety of sport, ever old and ever new. All those ideas which bred sorrow and fear are known in their truth and thus become the seed of joy. For you are certain beyond all proof that you can never die. That though you change, change is part of your own nature. The great enemy is become the great ally. And now, rooted in this perfection, yourself becomes the very tree of life. Kabbalah. You have a fulcrum for your lever. You are ready to understand that this pulsation of unity is itself duality, and therefore, in the highest and most sacred sense, still sorrow and illusion. So go on with the 111. Huh. You won't experience bliss until you dissolve in the none, none, none. Having comprehended this, aspire yet again, even unto the fourth of the gifts of the law, unto the end of the path, even unto light. Light, light, light. I pray you, be patient with me in that which I shall write concerning light. For here is a difficulty, ever increasing, in the use of words. Moreover, I am myself carried away constantly and overwhelmed by the sublimity of this matter, so that plain speech may whirl into lyric when I would plod peaceably with didactic expression. My best hope is that you may understand by virtue of the sympathy of your intuition, even as two lovers may converse in language as unintelligible to others as it seems silly, wanton, and dull, or as in that other intoxication given by ether, the ethereal, the partaker's commune with infinite wit or wisdom as the mood takes them. By means of a word, or even just a gesture, being initiated to apprehension by the subtlety of the drug. So may I, that am inflamed with love of this light, and drunken on the wine ethereal of this light, communicate not so much with your reason and intelligence, but with that principle hidden in yourself, which is ready to partake with me. Even so, may man and woman become mad with love. No word being spoken between them, because of the induction, as it were, of their souls. And your understanding will depend upon your rightness for perception of my truth. Moreover, if so be that light in you be ready to break forth, then light will interpret to you these dark words in the language of light, even as a string inanimate, duly adjusted, will vibrate to its peculiar tone, struck on another chord. Read, listen, therefore, not only with the eye and brain, but with the rhythm of the life which you have attained by your will to love, quickened to dancing measure by these words, which are the movements of the wand of my will to love, and so to enkindle your life to light. In this mood did I interrupt myself in the writing of this my little book, and for 2 days and nights sleeplessly have I made consideration, wrestling vehemently with my spirit, lest by haste or carelessness I might fall, failing towards you. In exercise of will and of love are implied motion and change, but in life is gained a unity which moves and changes only in pulse or in phase, and is even as music. Yet in the attainment of this life, you will already have experienced that the quintessence thereof is pure light, an ecstasy, formless, and without bound or mark. Ah, yes, in this light, naught exists, and therefore have men called it silence, darkness, and nothing. But in this, as in all other effort to name it, is the root of every falsity and misapprehension, since all words imply some duality. Therefore, though I call it light, it is not light, no absence of light even. Many also have sought to describe it by contradictions, but to no avail. It can only be experienced. All of this is just a trigger.